Brothers and sisters, I warn you, we cannot develop any country where we offer criminals for public office. In the Green Party, they put up a man, he's a double deportee, facing charges in America for firearm and ammunition, possession of narcotics, deported not once, but twice. Ladies and gentlemen, that person is still on the ballot paper. You know what this means? We are criminalizing the democratic institutions in Trinidad and Tobago. These are the kind of people they let loose. People who under their poster, you don't put vote ILP, you put wanted by the police. When they come to your gate, you must ask for the police certificate of good character, not their manifesto. There's a next candidate fired by a casino for thieving. A next one in Princess Song, she was fired by Republic Bank for fraud. Everywhere you go, their candidates are turning out to be crooks. One in San Fernando by the name of Regan Boxell. This is a candidate in San Fernando in Bonrepaux Navet. This man is before the court on charges, larceny, robbery with violence. He has been known to the police in matters and offenses involving kidnapping. These are the candidates that they are offering to you. This candidate for Bonrepaux Navet have a warrant on file by the police of Trinidad and Tobago. When we criminalize public representative institutions, our democracy collapses. What does Jack wanna do? He assemble a group of bandits, a group of crooks, and put them for your children and for you to vote for them. So I ask you to keep guard, stand firm, look at the quality of their candidates, look at the quality of our candidates, and take an important decision. On October 21, you vote for the United National Congress. You vote for the Congress of the People. You vote for the NJAP. Long live the rising sun.